Do pre neku godinu u Srbiji jedino mesto na kom su se školovali budući novinari bio je Fakultet političkih nauka u Beogradu. Danas postoje razni kursevi akademije koji nude otkrivanje novinarskog zanata. I onima na kursevima i onima na fakultetu jasan je značaj iskustva. U organizaciji OSCE, britanske ambasade, tri studentkinje novinarstva imali su jedinstvenu priliku da iskuse kako rade neki londonski mediji. And don't forget all I told you. Dok srpski tabloidi u velikoj meri utiču na značajne političke teme I to nekažnjeno činjeći sa brojnim greškama, u Britaniji je to ipak drugačije. Daily Star je klasičan britanski red paper tabloid koji je uspešan I zbog formule mix sporta, glamura I slavnih. Urednik Daily Star Sandeja ima diplomu inženjera fizike, a o svojim početcima u novinarstvu kaže:
I learned more in the first week of working as a journalist than I did in a year of doing a postgraduate training. Yes, you need to be able to have shorthand, yes, you need an understanding of law, what you can and can't say about people. Yes, you need someone to sort of polish your writing style. But when it comes down to it, until you've actually sat there in front of the screen ready to write your first story, that's when you actually learn. So it's experience. Experience over education, but you need the education first.
Iako u ovom tabloidu prednjače fotografije sportista I polunagih žena, zaposleni svoj posao shvataju ozbiljno. A imali smo priliku I da sa nekadašnjim ratom dopisnicom iz Sarajeva razgovaramo o britanskim medijima I o tome da li klasični mediji, novine I radio, gube značaj.
You know, the radio is something that you can take with you anywhere. You know, it's a medium. It is the most portable medium, really. You know, you can't take a television anywhere, everywhere. And you know, the small screens are still that you know you might get on a phone, or they're not really very satisfying. Whereas I think radio journalism, and it maintains that very intimate connection with the listener. I think
you're listening to the BBC World Service. I'm Julian Marshall with NewsHour.
Now I hardly dare do this with a master of coffee, but I got here a cup of Bush House canteen coffee. Made
from its smell, it does smell like canteen coffee. But in fairness, let me have a taste. Hopefully it's not too hot.
Your verdict?
It's okay. It's okay. Not when
Ukoliko pratite Team News Hour od početka, to jest od redakcijskog sastanka na kom se predlažu teme za taj dan, do razvijanja svake pojedinačne priče, kontaktiranja sagovornika, zakazivanja termina u studijima širom sveta, montaže priloga, noćna smena od 10 sati vam kao posmatraču proleti. Iako je provao skoro 12 sati u redakciji, ipak sa dozom humora, Jonathan objašnjava kako noćne smene njemu, kao novinaru News Hour-a, izgledaju.
How does it feel working night shifts?
That's the worst bit. It gets worse with time. If you're a late night person like me, it's quite fun at the beginning. But after 8 years, your sleeping is all over the place, and sometimes you need prescription drugs to help you, which I may or may not do right now.
You know, if you actually enjoy coming into work and being part of these developing stories and working with a team of other people who are equally committed, then you'll have a great time. Just be aware that, you know, it's not all about the fame and the money, because there's very little of that. You've got to do it because you enjoy it. That's my advice.
Do you understand what's happening? Who's doing what?
Iako prvi sat emisije idu uživo, u studiju se ne osjeti tenzija. Nekako je sve dobro uigrano. Od tima slušalci čuju samo prezentere emisije te večeri, koji šarmom, ali I veoma dobrom upućenošću u teme daje prepoznatljiv pečat NewsHour-u. Tu su I dežurni producent koji brine o vremenu priloga intervjua, dva tonska tehničara I naravno dežurni urednik koji brine o celokupnom sadržaju.
So that's the division of labor really in the studio.
Svetska služba BBC-a koristi najveću mrežu dopisnika na svetu. A celodnevno se emituju svetske vesti na engleskom I na još 32 jezika, dok publika broji više od 182 miliona slušalaca. U nizu hodnika Bush House-a nalaze se I različite jezičke sekcije svetske službe. Od afričke, makedonske, albanske do srpske, u kojima uglavnom I rade ljudi iz tih zemalja.
Ovdje sad.
Ne, ovdje?
Ne, sledeći u rad.
Srpska redakcija BBC-a i Beogradski radio B92 zajedno radi informativnu emisiju Svet u 2.
Iz Londona Danica Ilić, iz Beograda Vesna Dobrosavljević.
BBC i B92. Svet u 2.
A u čemu je značaj prakse za mlade studente, objašnjava glavni urednik srpske redakcije BBC-a.
Mislim da je ovo što BBC na relativno malo,